mermaid pumpkin that I made out of Sculpey. So, here's the pumpkin. It was just a quick thing that I threw together. It has a core of aluminum foil. Went into a ball, rolled the Sculpey into flat sheets, and then did little coils that I just lined up on the sheets, put it all up, squished it together, and figured, well, we'll just see how it goes. I think I'm going to do this side because it kind of faces up more. So I have my Dremel and my vacuum and my coffee and my puppy. Super important. Gotta have your puppy. Okay. Definitely need a thinner way to cut the top because it's got a little out of control, a little thicker of a cut than I wanted. I gotta get all that foil out of there. Fun. I think I need a scoop. In there, basically one lining of foil. So I figure once I cut it, it's going to reflect more light back. I kind of feel like it'll look cool, and if it doesn't, I can always take it out later. Slap that pumpkin. Okay. To draw it on here so that I can carve it with some level of decency. There. Okay, I need my phone to find an image, and then I'm going to draw it on there, and then the phone will go back and record.
Fine. Some pine trees and a cliff in the background, howling wolf, and I threw in a little bat because I just thought, well, I need something up there. It's a big open space. So, simple. Shouldn't be too hard. Got my carving tip here ready to roll. So we'll see how it goes. came out pretty well. My bat fell off, but I am going to attempt repair so that he'll go on like that. So we'll see. I read you can just apply more Sculpey, rebake it, and that apparently it holds. But that's kind of a dangly thing. If it doesn't work, I can just buzz that off and, you know, still good to go. Alright, let me get some Sculpey and see what I can do. Could just jab a pin in there, make a new bat, and adhere it to that. I don't know if I can do that in a way that it'll work. Let's see. Something to cut. I think I'll have some jabby thing. Have a cutty thing, surely. Ah. It's a little magnet. Whoop. Just clicks right in there.
All right. I don't like that as good as my original bat. Maybe I'll put it on, maybe I won't. Put it on just to see if I can put it on. Mediocre bat. Alright, well, let's see. If this breaks off, doesn't matter so much because I'll just trim it off as long as I don't break into the moon. If I break the moon, then I'll be a little annoyed. How's this supposed to fit? It's supposed to fit like that. So then the pin, more or less, go in that way. I say cooey to this. I don't think this is going to pan out. I think once broken off, little bat is done for. Hope. Thankfully, this is one of the thickest parts of this whole pumpkin, which was not in any way, shape, or form intentional, but I think it's going to pay off here. Now, really, I kind of need this turned a little more. Since this bat is bigger, it might be easier just to trim this bat down more. What do I want to do? I want to make little eyeballs. Just made a ridge in his back. Ooh, I'm gonna throw him around a little bit. And hopefully. Oh, that's gotta. Huh. Come on, buddy. I know you wanna be part of this.
So, it's on sort of a weird angle, but I'll take it. Little Mr. Bat's there. And I want to get a little piece on the inside over the metal, just to kind of maybe help hold it in there. Make it a little stronger, perhaps. Overdone it and squishing them on there, and I can see some of the metal here. Ugh, just making it worse. Poop. Let's see. That in there. Not really done this before. So I'm kind of having to re-sculpt the whole bat here, because in getting them on, I butchered them. All a learning process. It's like to get these cool little flappy angles on them, so he looks like a proper Halloween bat. Can't say he looks like an actual bat, but it's not what we're going for. Okay, I managed to fold them over. I'm not thrilled with them. I wish the original would have stayed on. He was much more angular. But I think this is one of these things you just gotta go, okay, enough is enough. This whole guy was just for practice, really, anyways, and even though, of course, I will neurotically save it forever. It's not like it's gonna go and win an award or something. It's just a practice bit. So did this, it ends up where it looks like a second fang. Purely accidental, but pretty cool. I think I need to put that down before I break something. Alright, done, 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 done. In there, a little clay group, whatever, chokey thing. Get in there, get in there. Done, done. Little piece of clay, back in the clay box. And, piece is thicker than a half, may need bulking outlet, no. Bake on oven-proof glass or metal surface at 275 for 15 minutes per quarter inch of thickness. Maybe that's like an eighth of an inch. I think if I do 275 for about 10 minutes, I should be good. All right. So since I'm baking on Mr. Bat anyways, I thought I'd fix this top, and so I put a ream of Sculpey around it and have now pressed this into it. And so I'm just going to smooth out the edges and then bake, and I'll have a good fitting top and a bat. That's a big, big thumbs up right there. So cool, cool. Going to get that done.